So, continuing on with our autumn cleanse theme and the metal element and the lung and the large intestines, and really just looking at what emotional toxins are we holding on to and what emotional load do we need to release. Probably the biggest two ones in the metal element are grief and guilt. So, the next little one that we're going to really address is guilt and the way that guilt shows up within our body is quite unique because we hold on to it. So there's an aspect of trauma with the guilt that we have. We're either traumatized at one stage of our life, or someone was traumatized at one stage of our life and sort of modeled that to us, and we associate guilt with that. So guilt will have a movement about it. We either do things because we feel guilty, because the guilt is being laid on us. Or we're driven to do things because we hold the guilt within ourselves. Where did we learn guilt? Who did we learn guilt from? Like, how far back did guilt run in our family where it actually served a purpose? A lot of the guilt, and I say this, a lot of the guilt is female related. Our mother's guilt, our parenting guilt, our multiple roles guilt, the in it, and it's always coming from a I should have done more, I should be more, or I'm not enough, or this is not enough, or having a moment to ourselves, having stepping down and the feeling the guilt with that. So there is quite a bit of trauma with that because there's quite a bit of baggage. So we just keep on reinforcing. We felt a little bit guilty and now we feel more guilty. And then the next time it happens, we feel the same guilt build up and it just sort of has that snowball effect. So then we end up responding the way that we respond and moving from a place of guilt because we've got a bit of trauma in us. So guilt actually takes a few points to clear. When you're looking at your meridians here, I've spoken to most of you, but if I haven't, and you haven't heard about meridians before, then you've got a nurturing and a control aspect. So guilt is in our lung meridian, and it needs to be nurtured from, so we need to fill up our spleen meridian to be nurtured into the lung to have an overflow so that we can move past whatever guilt. So we need to have enough sweetness in our life for us to not get stuck on what makes us feel guilty. Or the feeling anxiety or insecurity or the fear of not meeting up needs to be small enough that then the guilt from what we're feeling can flow in. Or essentially we need to have enough motivation to move forward, enough heat, enough all of those kind of things to actually move forward within the guilt. Okay, so there's a few little points to guilt. So we're going to start with thinking about guilt, and we're in the start of our eyebrow, which is our bladder meridian. So essentially we're dulling down the fear of not being enough to be able to move forward. So we're connecting with guilt. Guilt, I feel guilty, mother's guilt, all the different ways that we feel guilt. And then we're going to under eye. So we're still in our, well, we're in our stomach meridian here. So we're filling ourselves up, we're nourishing ourselves. And we're trying to then fill up our bucket of sweetness and nourishment so that we can flow through. And then we're in our spleen meridian. So this is just down the seam of our t-shirt, sort of where just under chest height. Yeah, and we're tapping our spleen. So we're still connecting with guilt. And you know, the fear of missing out because of guilt, or the fear that I've missed out, or I can't get that time back. I can't rewind that kind of, that's the guilt that's coming here. And then we're collarbone, so we're back down to like our kidney meridian, feeling anxious, not feeling grounded, not being able to be steady in our feet with the guilt that we're feeling. Not being able to move past it or speak up is this kind of guilt. And then we are on our little finger, which is our large intestines. And that essentially, no, our lung. And back to our collarbone. Still connecting with guilt. And you can see how much guilt ties you up, right? It's not the easiest emotion to shift. because it affects the body and has a really interesting connection to all 14 meridians. And then we're going to our gamut spot. So our gamut spot is just like our adrenals, and we're coming into a nice little eye pattern with this. So we're eyes open, eyes closed, coming to the subconscious. Eyes open, going down to the left with our eyeballs, back to the middle, down to the right with our eyeballs, back to the middle, big circle round. If there's any spot that sort of is really sticky, iron it out, circle back, hum, count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then we do the whole sequence again. So your eyebrow, start of your eyebrow, guilt, the complexity of guilt, under the eye, guilt. Under the arm. Collarbone. This little spot underneath our sternum. Little finger. Just on your nail bed. Collarbone, and then we're holding our sequence, our gamut point, while we eye roll from the floor all the way up to the ceiling. So I would say the same things. You do this 3 times in the first hour to sort of have that immediate shift, and then I would be doing it once a day for whatever that finds. Or keep the little video, save it, and use it for when the guilt kicks in, so that then you kind of are feeling the baggage of the guilt, and then you can step out of it, tap it away, and then step back into the circumstances to actually start to break the cycle of guilt. Like, as females, we've got a good few generations of guilt cycles to be breaking out. And I know, especially as a mum of a girl, like, I use it all the time, and I need to catch myself all like out so that I'm not then parenting her through that same guilt. Awesome. I hope